I have built what I consider to be the ultimate racing toothpick. My name's FlyOFPV, and let's get to it. This is based on the BetaFPV HX115, using the same frame, same motors, same flight controller, but as you can see, it's a little different. So let's get our props off and let's talk about it. So first thing you'll notice is that I do have it underpropped, and that is actually for a reason. And that reason is I'm used to having a lot of stick throw, a lot of resolution on my radio, and I recently have switched to the Taranis XLite. And why I did that, I will have a video out later, probably a bit after this one. Some other stuff I want to cover first. Yes, there'll be a video on that. About why I switched to basically a thumb-only radio. But let's first get this antenna taken care of. Yeah, let's open this up, and you guys will see exactly what I've done to make this the ultimate race pick. And I admit, I am filming this off a GoPro Session, so I don't have any idea if what I'm doing is actually going to be in frame or not, so we're going to find out. When it comes time. But yeah, so there we go. Take our canopy off. The first thing you'll notice is probably going to be the T-style antennas here that I've got. They are TBS Tracer. And this is done for a variety of reasons. Number one being, of course, the latency. I used to use Spectrum's SRXL2 protocol with this little guy, and I could really feel the latency in it. This specific system with the tracer, I can't feel any latency at all. The instant I send something to the quad on my radio, it's the instant response. So there's a little nano receiver here. It's tiny, fits under my little sled here. We do have a TBS Unify Pro 32 Nano sitting right there. Got the little UFL connector, kind of just some, I think it's a Wolf Whoop Amazon brand Cloverleaf. And of course, we have the all-important, we have a kattifps Baby Ritel. This is the version with the Starlight sensor. And I chose this one for actually a variety of reasons. The first being that, number one, the Ritel is often thought of as being the king of all analog cameras, and then it's the highest def, colors look the best, and it's just generally the favored camera. Of course, many people prefer the Ritel, the mini Ritel or the micro Ritel. This is the baby Ritel, built for toothpicks like this, and the tiny hawk, of course, but yeah, there she is. And there's not really much else to say. I do have this little piece of tape in here just to keep the antenna out of the way of the props. I think that does a good job of it right there. But anyway, let's put this aside for a sec. Let's talk about props. So first thing you'll notice is I have in my two hands the 3-inch prop from HQ Prop, and I have a 2.5-inch prop from Gemfan. Links to all these will be in the description. And basically what I found is that with a 3-inch prop on this quad, what happened was, especially with the low throttle resolution and low stick throw, this thing was just stupid fast. It was not controllable for me. I've been flying, you know, drone quads like the Hyperlite Floss and the 5-3-3 Switchback. They all have been very controllable for me, even at the 5-inch race quad class. So I decided to bump it down to, these gem fans were just these rather HQ props were just rather not as controllable for me in this stage of flight. So I decided to bump it down to a gem fan 25 Gemfan, yeah, Flash 2540-3. These were the prop that I ran on my Tiny Hawk Freestyle, and I got great performance out of them, and so I thought, you know, why not run them on the HX115 here? It's basically the same wheelbase, just in a 3-inch form factor instead of a 2.5-inch form factor, so why not? And that's the flight footage you're going to see. The only noticeable difference that I found besides increased maneuverability and handling with a reduced speed was they actually did provide a decent bit of noise in the camera. And I think that's because when you have props that are meant to be pulling a much smaller quad, even by half an inch, it's going to underpower. It's going to make the motors have to work harder than the 3-inch. So we'll be working our way up to 3-inch, but for now, that is why you'll see that I have actually underpropped. So yes, these are all of the props that I've used with this quad. I will say that this particular one from HQ, they're very high quality. They have great maneuverability, speed, durability is not there yet. Unlike some of the, say, like Ethics P3 or Ethics other Gemfan variants and in 5-inch, the 5-inch quads, you really can't just crash into things with these. These will break. They're very brittle. They bend easily. After like one crash, I had to switch props. That to me is unacceptable. Anyway, let's get into the flight footage here. All right, so fly away from the future here again. And this time, I think next bit of the video is going to only focus on the bit where I run 3-inch props on the HX115, and underpropping will come in a different video. This is just because I want to show off the HX115 in the smoothest, best flying configuration I possibly can, and I feel that it flies the best and demonstrates the best flight characteristics in its 3-inch propped configuration instead of its 2.5-inch propped configuration. So that is the flight footage we will be discussing today. Can you hear the cicadas? It's kind of wild. Dog walkers over there.
Dump this little guy out.
Oh no.
Pregnant?
Looks like it.
That's unfortunate.
Cicadas, 17 years in the ground, come out, molt, have sex, you die. I mean, that's brutal. That really sucks. Imagine, you spend 18 years buried underground, your only job is to go out and have sex. And some don't even get to do that. It's fucking wild. It's a rough life. You can really hear him now. My God. It's really fucking loud cicadas. Metal company. Thank you. I got company up here. Bam. See if we can sneak around over here. Got people noticing. Yeah. All clear. That's what I like to see. Need some medication there. I'm gonna take that, make sure nobody accidentally ingests it. There it is. Alright. Let's see. Let's get our quad out. Get our black sheep gear bag out. There it is. That looks good right there. Alright, let's get set up.
Right, so the first thing we're going to get into this this bit of DVR is, you can see here I'm kind of just taking it around, seeing how fast I can get it, keep it reasonably under control, kind of practicing the figure eights. Anyway, the goal of this flight this morning was to just test out how it acted on full three-inch propellers, and I think the answer is quite well, as you're going to see throughout this flight. It has great handling, great control, a good bit of speed too. And the only complaint I have, again, with these propellers is how brittle they are. Now, luckily, at the end of this clip, you're going to see that I did kind of crash into a tree, and I had to turtle mode my way out. But I didn't record that, and the props afterward looked quite fine. And I think maybe I just got unlucky with the previous two batches of props I had received from Gemfan, because this specific set, this neon yellow set, seems to withstand the test of everything I throw at it. So yeah, we kind of nail that power loop there. Yeah, there's not much else to say. I'm going to let the flight footage speak for itself. The last thing I do want to add though is that if you've come here looking for a 5-inch quad replacement, something that flies like a 5-inch and a 3-inch package, this is not it. This is a small 3-inch toothpick class quad that you really want to save only for these small tight environments, because it will not fly like a 5-inch. It doesn't have the fling, it doesn't have the weight, and it is just super light, super fast, and just the flight characteristics are not there. Anyway, as always, I will be letting you guys watch the rest of the DVR, and you can decide if you would like to buy it. And I guess that brings me to the final question of, should you build it slash buy it? And the answer to that is going to depend on what kind of pilot you are. I am a very kind of aggressive, fast, I do a lot of snap turns, split S's when I fly. So for me, this setup works just fine. Tracer has one of the best latencies in the entire FPV industry. And the quad itself is incredibly light, agile, and very easy to handle. So gets my recommendation. Obviously, it depends on what kind of pilot you are, but if you're looking to be a competitive toothpick racer, this quad is definitely for you.